make everything a bit more exciting, don't they? Hey everyone, it's Sin here, and today we're going to do some engineering and stuff, and I'm going to show you how to control a servo motor in LabVIEW using an Arduino Uno, following on from our last lesson. Controlling a servo motor in LabVIEW is quite easy. All we need to do is set up the correct VIs from the LINX palette with our desired properties. So how do we set up a servo motor? If we look at the circuit schematic, it's quite easy. All we need to do is provide plus 5 volts, ground, and a PWM signal with a variable duty cycle to control the servo's rotation. We can achieve this by utilizing pin 11 on the Arduino, which can be configured to output a PWM signal. Now, how did I work this out? By looking at the data sheet, of course. If we look at the data sheet for the Hextronik HXT900, we can see it provides the performance specifications and at the very end the important stuff, the pulse cycle and the pulse width that's required. Here we can ignore the pulse cycle, as we only really care about the pulse width, which will determine the position of the servo arm in this case. 450 microseconds, 90 degrees left from center, 2450 microseconds, 90 degrees right from center. Well, that's how I'll be defining it for this project anyway. Now, this datasheet doesn't have any pinouts for the servo, but I found it on a generic SG90 servo datasheet, but it is still correct for the HXT900 also. Here we can see we have a nice illustration of the pulse cycle. Just be aware that the diagram shown is a little bit misleading in the datasheet, as the duty cycle label is actually the pulse width, where the duty cycle is actually the ratio of the on to off time of the signal. So this is the pulse width divided by the period of the signal. So in this case, it would be 5 to 10% duty cycle, but you would have a pulse between 1 and 2 milliseconds. Now that we understand how to wire our servo, let's start the fun part in LabVIEW. If we look at the front panel, we see of course our circuit diagram, our general controls from last time which show the device name and a stop control. On the right we have a vertical slider for controlling the pulse width in the range specified from the datasheet in increments of 50 microseconds. And on the servo we have an angle numeric display which shows the real-time angle of the servo arm that corresponds to the set pulse width. Now let's look at the block diagram. We can see the code is very similar to our first example of the LED, with a couple of minor changes. Similarly to last time, we initialize the communications to the Arduino, then we initialize the channel we want to control the servo on. This is to configure it for PWM output. We then set the pulse width in the while loop, and here we convert the pulse width to an angle using a basic linear fit. And finally, we close all references when the while loop ends. Now, to access these additional VIs for controlling the servo, we right-click, select MakerHub, select LINX, select Sensors, select Motion, and lastly, select Servo and pin it. We see three VIs for controlling the servo. Open, which initializes and sets the configuration in the LINX firmware for the selected channels to support PWM output for a servo. Right, which allows you to set the pulse width for the specified servo channel. And lastly, close, which closes the reference to the channels configured as servo channels on the Arduino and LINX firmware. And that's it. Now you know how to control a servo on LabVIEW. You can use my code as a starting point for your projects. Now let's see this in action. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please like, share, comment, and subscribe. Catch you in the next video.